Welcome to the Commercial Service Regulator Webinar Series presented by Control Southern and Fisher Regulator Technologies. By watching this series, you will learn about the operation, selection, application, maintenance, and troubleshooting of commercial service regulators in the natural gas industry.
In this video, we're going to look at the basic principles of operation of a self-operated regulator. Pay attention to the downstream pressure slider bar and the downstream demand slider bar. These are two of the variables that we will look at in this video. And shown here is one of Fisher's commercial service regulators. As a direct operated regulator, this device's purpose is to reduce a high inlet pressure, shown here in red, down to a steady outlet pressure, shown in blue, so that the downstream equipment at your facility will run safely and efficiently. This regulator is composed of a diaphragm, which is elastomer material with a spring on the upper side, and outlet pressure, shown in blue, on the bottom side. The diaphragm is connected by a lever to the valve disc or seat, which can restrict flow by moving towards the orifice or away from the orifice to allow gas flow from the inlet side, shown in red. The spring's purpose is to allow the user the ability to adjust the pressure at which the regulator begins flowing gas. The diaphragm will move upward if outlet pressure increases, which will move the valve disc closer to the orifice. The opposite will happen if outlet pressure decreases. As outlet pressure decreases, the demand moves downward, pivoting the lever and pulling the valve disc to the right, away from the orifice. The most important takeaway is that the only way the disc will move in any direction to restrict or allow more flow is if the diaphragm senses a change in outlet pressure. Now that we understand what makes a regulator operate, let's look at what's happening inside the regulator while it's installed on your commercial building. If the regulator senses decreasing outlet pressure due to an increase in flow demand from your building's heater or other equipment, the subsequent force change on the diaphragm will move it downward and pull the valve plug away from the orifice, resulting in additional flow to match the increased demand. This isn't a temporary decrease in outlet pressure. Outlet pressure will stay at its decreased value as long as the heater or other equipment is on. In order to meet the flow demand from the heater, the flow area created by the valve disc must be open a certain amount, and the only way the disc will stay in that position is if outlet pressure stays at the decreased value. We refer to this as droop. Let's watch the animation again. This time, pay attention to the pressure gauge shown on the right side of the screen and the downstream demand gauge below on the regulator. In order for the regulator to open to meet the increasing demand, outlet pressure has to decrease, and the outlet pressure will stay in place as long as the flow demand is high. Now, let's look at what the regulator does when the flow demand from the building's heater decreases. When flow demand decreases, we know that the valve disc needs to move towards the orifice to restrict flow, and the only way that this will happen is for outlet pressure to increase back up to where it was initially. Again, the only reason outlet pressure returned to its initial set point was that the flow demand is again low. If flow demand increases a little, downstream pressure will decrease a little. If flow demand increases a large amount, downstream pressure will decrease a large amount.
Thank you for viewing the Commercial Service Regulator webinar series presented by Control Southern and Fisher Regulator Technologies. For more information about these products, please contact us. For Georgia, Alabama, and Tennessee, contact Control Southern at 770 770- 425-3100 and ask for inside sales. For all other territories, please visit the Emerson Process Management website shown here and search for your local Fisher Regulators representative. Subscribe to the Control Southern YouTube channel for more regulator videos.